Y'all ready? Hey, look at that book. All right. We him. This is an attempt to collect a debt. We're going to look at the book of Kauf. Kauf. Beth. 3:3-1. Let me look at this too first. Give me Kauf, Beth, 2:14. That's for everybody. For those that don't know, you'll call it Peter. Last name Parker. Pizza Porker. Kauf. Beth is always for second. You some stuff you have first and second. You have first epistle, second epistle, first Timothy, second Timothy. We use Aleph for first, and then we use Beth for second. Listen. 2:14. Kauf. Listen.
Having eyes full of adultery.
That can do what?
Cannot cease from sin.
Listen.
Beguiling unstable souls.
Yes.
And heart that have exercised with covetous practices. Cursed children which have forsaken the right way.
That's something right there. He talked about, if you look at what he was talking about, having eyes full of adultery that cannot see from sin. You are in a committed relationship. Why are you looking at everything else? So you can't stop. And say you got a heart, you done exercised to do any practices. So that's why we start looking at, well, the change got to start first. Transformation need to start. And of course, we've been addressing the different issues that's going on, the social ills that's going on with our people globally. But the truth of the matter is, we got to address the issue that's going on with us inwardly. Y'all hear me? As he told her, he that is of the Yahudi is one that's on the inside. Y'all hear me? It's the inside. That's where the first circumcision had to start, the removing, the cutting. It needs to start with us. Y'all hear me? We look at the Zen to sort. And that's what we're trying to do now. We're trying to sort, which is one of your Aleph Beth. That's what we're trying to do now. We're trying to sort. We're trying to cut. We need to separate ourselves from some of these things. And the truth of the matter is, that's what hinders us on walk. Anytime you find yourself, I don't know, I think so, I kind of don't go, then other things come up. Regardless of what come up in my life, one option don't come up on the table is stop what I'm doing toward my salvation. That's first and foremost of why I made the transformation to do what I'm doing today. It's a mere fact that I want to be saved. So when different issues or different things might come over, different feelings or behavior come up, I always lay to the point of looking at why I'm here. It's the, first of all, to make sure that I'm saved. I fear spending the rest of my life in prison. I fear and I feared past and presently dying a sinner and burning in hell. These are the two reasons that keep me on the straight and narrow. I feared and I still fear. Y'all hear me? Because then what? Then what? See, a lot of y'all doing stuff, but you don't actually have anything. That fear, and I look at the person that controls that. The person that controls where I'll spend the rest of my life at is him. So it only makes sense, and we talked about again, why deal with policy enforcers instead of dealing with policy makers. So I'm going to the man that make policy, who make decrees. Isn't that right? By doing what he told me to do, regardless of realizing all these things are imminent. Some of us, he said, going to be cast into prison. Isn't that right? And some of us going to taste the death before he get back here. Not all. Some are going to taste the death before he get back here. So I look at whatever situation lies, it's to my benefit to make sure I serve and I commit my life to him that control every situation. Y'all hear me? Regardless of you fearing things, don't stop the fact that it happened. It's some people fear being robbed. It didn't mean they didn't get robbed. It's some women fear being raped. They still got raped. Y'all got me? So I'm trying to fear the man that controls the situation. That regardless if it happens, I'm going to serve him. Even when you look at Yahusha, he feared some situations. That's why he disappeared and got their presence. He didn't want the situation to happen. But then he looked at something that had to be done. Not my will, but your will being done. And what happens with us a lot of times, the things we've done and we're doing, they're not inside the parameter of his will. It's things that we want to do. Back to what we said. Give me over here before you get me that. We're going to finish that up. Give me that Romans again. 10:1. Listen, Romans 10:1.
Our key, my heart's desire and prayer to Allah Ahim for Yasharal is that they might be saved.
For
I bear them record that they have a zeal of Elohim,
but not
according to knowledge. For they, being ignorant of Elohim's Tzaddik, and going about to establish their own Tzaddik, have not submitted themselves unto the Tzaddik of Elohim. For the Mashiach is the end of the law for Tzaddik to every one that believeth.
So when we talk about what the problem again, not submitting themselves. And when we find Yahushua, the book told us he left us an example that we should follow his steps. Who did know what it's saying? Meaning everything he did, he made sure he stayed in the parameters of the law. And that's what you got to look at. Regardless of your feelings, regardless of what your expectation might be for yourself, you still got parameters. You can't go past these parameters. And that's what hindered a lot of us. You start looking at other people. You're not looking at what the law tells you to do. And a lot of times, that's what caused our problems. The book told you to be not envious of the who? Of the wicked. A lot of times, you look at people you're envious of, it ain't even people that are doing what's right. I guarantee you, you watch the every person that fall away, it's people they're envious of that ain't doing what's right. If you were envious of somebody that was right, you'd be doing what was right. Huh? Let's see something. Pick me up at the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 11. I will use 2 Corinthians instead of Allah for them. 11 to 1. Listen.
Would to Elohim you could bear with me a little in my folly.
And indeed.
Bear with me.
Why?
For I am jealous over you with an Elohim jealousy.
See that? That's the difference. He made sure you understood exactly how it worked. It wasn't just a kind of jealousy. I'm jealous of Leon because Leon making more money than me. I'm jealous of Leon because he wear better clothes. I'm jealous of Leon because of the car. He said, I'm jealous over you about, he talked about how Elohim is. He talked about his name being jealous. When you get outside the parameters of doing what you've been told to do, when you start to lean and you start to lurk over into other things that's outside of what our protocol is, that's the jealousy he had, that you don't turn away, that you don't move away from the truth. But a lot of times, your carnal jealousy is about carnal things that don't equate to no salvation. We're trying to look at what gets us to salvation. Y'all hear me? See if that's the 11th chapter. Let me see. Let me see, 11 chapter, Romans chapter 11. I'm going to need another pen, I think, this black one. I like this one right here. I like the one with that. I think that's impressive. Romans chapter 11. You mean 11 and about 11. We'll see what that says. Listen.
I say then, have they stumbled that they should fall? Elohim forbid, but rather through their fall, salvation is come unto the Gentiles for to provoke them to jealousy.
Whoa. Whoa. It was to provoke them to what?
Jealousy.
So what, are the Gentile clothes? Are the Gentile job? The Gentile's career? No, it was to provoke them to jealousy. They want to come back to try to do the will of Elohim. Once we saw how he started to bestow blessings upon the Gentile, that was supposed to provoke us to make us want to come back to do. But a lot of times, look at what people jealous of. That's bad. Why don't ever get people here jealous to want to try to do a good work? You usually find people being jealous of something, it don't even equate to salvation. So it makes no sense. So you see these terminology using, because you know what? You understand jealousy. You understand jealousy because most of you deal with it. But then you start talking about looking at it on a Ruach note. You know, right? When you start looking at trying to obtain the spirit, that's when you ought to be provoked. Y'all provoked by somebody finna get married, somebody else married. Why I ain't married? I think I should be married for somebody else. I don't know how you make those decisions based off somebody else. The decision you gotta be made gotta be based upon time, gotta be based upon maturity. Ain't that right? Gotta be based upon the right situation with the right person. A lot of times y'all just don't think. I'm just being honest, a lot of stuff y'all do, you don't think, and you start making bad decisions. Because that corner way going to wind up being something that's going to cause you to get yourself in a problem. Huh? Yeah. Come on back. Let's look at Cuff. Cuff, Beth, chapter 2. I just want to look at some. Listen.
Which have forsaken the right way.
What verse we at now? Verse 14 still?
15.
Verse 15. We have forsaken the right way and done what?
And are going astray.
And have gone astray. What happened?
Following the way of Balaam.
See that? Know what you ought to do, but you done forsook it. You done forsook it. Go do something else. You know it's bad that you sit around and know the right way and you let it go so you can go do what's wrong? He wound up killing Balaam. Now what's going to happen to you? Listen.
The son of Beor, who loved the wages of unrighteousness.
Listen.
But was rebuked for his iniquity.
Yes.
The dumb ass speaking with man's voice.
Did what?
Forbade the madness of the prophet.
You want one? See, some of them be driven with anger to do wrong. So you can be driven to the wrong intent. Listen.
These are wells without water.
What else?
Clouds that are carried with a tempest.
Yes.
To whom the mist of darkness is reserved forever.
That's us. A lot of us, we got to look, but inwardly. That's why we got to make sure we don't just present a look on the outside, but inwardly, you got to start looking at the heart. Look at some of the behavior like it have been manifested. Inappropriate conversation, touching, other stuff you do, you're lying, you're manipulating, you're hypocriting. Just everything you put on the table you're doing, and it's because you possess a look, but you hadn't started with the heart. So we got to start looking at the first thing, and we got to make sure we clean up this heart. That's what Daoud said, creating me a clean heart, renewing me the right ruach. He didn't say, fix up my outside, make my outside look good. And a lot of times, that's where our fall comes. The clothes don't keep you from committing sin. You can have better sex with these clothes on. Because you ain't got to pull off no britches. You're a female. So a lot of stuff you're doing, it's easier. But you start looking at the fact, when it comes down to living right, we got to start with the heart. So when you wear certain things, it alludes to something. You got me? It has a value to it. When you look at, he told you about the virtuous woman. He told you, what was her clothing?
Strength and honor.
Think about you. You have no honor. You have no integrity. So what good are your clothes? That's just being honest. I've been lying. I've been cheating. I've been inappropriate. I've been doing something. What good are your clothes? You're doing the same thing like Balaam did. You forsake the right way. You're going the wrong way. And you try to say you've been warned about your behavior. A lot of times, y'all just straightforward. Y'all go right on to the same thing you look at. When sinners enticed you, what he told you to do? I don't want nobody to go wrong with me. I need somebody to be able to stand. Amen. If I got weak, I want you better to say, no, we can't do that. We got to stand. A lot of y'all don't consider that. These folks will take you down and run you right on straight to hell. And y'all don't even consider this stuff. When y'all start looking at even, when you look at 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 1. Goodness, it depends. We got to get used to each other. Just take your time. Take your time. Don't try to write too fast. See, this thing here, envious of the old pen. It's covetous, but it ain't producing the work yet. Before you get jealous, now do the work. That's a skinny, ripe cat. I did all that. That's me and the pen. We'll work. I guess. Come on. I just don't like it.
Am I not an apostle?
Uh-huh.
Am I not free?
What happened?
Have I not seen Yahushua HaMashiach, our Elohim?
Yeah.
Are not ye my work in Elohim?
Yeah.
If I be not an apostle unto others,
then doubtless
I am to you.
For what happened?
The seal of mine apostleship are ye in Elohim.
What happened?
Mine answer to them that do examine me is this.
What happened?
Have we not power to eat and to drink?
And what else? See that? Got authority to eat and drink. Isn't that right? Without authority, we can make decisions. I have the choice I can eat or drink. What else you got?
Have we not power to lead about a couth, a wife, as well as other apostles, and well, as
he
the...
Said, he could just say a shim. That's going to cover wife. It's going to cover wife or woman or female. But that's fine. He said that. Well, it said, but then it said sister, so a couth would be correct for those of them. Thank you. Oh, yeah. You go ahead and be jealous, Heifer. Oh, Kuth. Sisters. Y'all got it? So we make sure we spell this stuff right. We don't want to get back out wrong. Somebody, you know how to spell Mashiach? She's trying to think about it. You trying to think about how to spell it? You know how to spell it? Before I put it up here? Okay. How many of y'all don't know how to spell it? Christ is a bastard. Mashiach. It's actually for anointed one. I got it, Mashiach. I'd have been misspelling Shamayim too. How many of y'all do not spell Shamayim? One, two. You know how to spell Shamayim? Or is it Ray don't know how to spell it? Heaven. What are they gonna call heaven? Y'all all right? Shamayim, y'all got it? Yashraal? Y'all got. Somebody had two A's, I heard. Y'all have Yashraal as well? How many of y'all do not spell Yashraal? Okay, good, good. Go ahead. And say, have we not power to do what?
Lead about a Akuth.
The lead about an Akuth.
A Neshim.
A Neshim.
As well as other apostles, and as the Aki of Alahim and Cuff.
And Cup. Cuff. What's the name be for Peter? The reason why I kind of had y'all to go here and look at this, because I want the men to learn, the Neshim to learn, the Neshim and the a noose to learn our positions and learn about how to learn how to lead about. That's being under, especially y'all taking on the role of leadership as being a husband. You definitely want to know how to lead about. When you look at him, you start talking about what they had. A lot of times you try to take on positions and do things. It first started in our homes. Y'all got me? Decision making, leadership, exemplifying and showing. And a lot of y'all, at being honest with you, are poor leaders. Just poor leaders. That's just being honest. Poor leadership. And poor leadership is going to make for a poor home. That's being honest. Because if you look at taking on these positions as husbands, you got to start looking at provider. Y'all hear me? You got to have some type of rationale. There's got to be some discipline. There's got to be some foresight. Even when you look at him talking about a man being a bishop, he said if a bishop can't, what was again? So if he can't take care of his own house, how are you going to take care of the house of Elohim? It doesn't make sense. You can't even rule in your own house. You can't decision make. You're led versus you actually being the leader. It makes no sense. So I want our men to start looking at what we have to do. And it comes down to our home. You're responsible for your home, for the welfare of your home, for leading about your homes. You hear me? That's why he said we know how to lead about an Aku. Y'all hear me? An Neshim. We know how to lead about them. Isn't that right? As well as a noose. We know how to lead them about. Y'all hear me? And that's the same thing I want y'all to learn how to do, becoming responsible enough to understand your position. And looking at, we had to set the precedence. When he came down and gave the word, he gave it to us. He gave it to us. Y'all, he didn't give it to the one we were responsible for taking and putting it and making sure it operate in our homes. Y'all hear me? So I want to make sure we understand our position. When it come down, I'm talking about us and possessing and us partaking of, we as the men got to take it and we got to give it to our homes. And to our wives, we got to set the standard. We can't let them lead us. But a lot of y'all, the truth be told, you ain't going to be nothing but another Adam and Eve story. We know our name is Ka'ua. Oh, my goodness. Ka'ua. What you do to dry the vaginal? Let me tell y'all something. A lot of them in here, they look crazy when I start telling about all them chemicals. Let me tell y'all something that'll come to mind. I had only one call me and told me, say, you know what? So you're exactly right. All that stuff not good for you. Putting that stuff in your vaginal areas. But see, they trained us and they programmed us and got us in here and they messed us up. That's why we're in such a mess now, being under with you. Then y'all seen all the Crisco getting used up. Then they want to say some KY jelly ain't natural, give you something else to mess you up. These folks don't care nothing about us. They want to break up the homes, another way to get you sterile. They don't like that. I'm going to tell y'all the truth now. They know what they're trying to do. They know exactly what they're trying to do. And these folks done program and done mess you up. Just like y'all putting these code texts and everything. Well, these folks make this stuff. You can't trust these people. A lot of people that make them men. What a man know about making something that go in a woman vaginal? What he got going now, he ain't making you. Who made it? These people ain't sensitive to no need or no construction of a woman. These folks make anything and give it to us. And then saying they bust you up later on, you're messed up. Say we got to put a darn water hose down there to try to get wet. I don't know where that came from. I might not be myself right now. But just being honest, they messed us up. They messed the men up too. They gave us all this stuff here, done it, got you sterile. Sitting here, you keep using your hand. And I told you, when he saw the man, he said, ain't good for him to be alone. I don't know what he was doing, but whatever it was, he said, ain't good. It didn't involve no woman. He said, ain't good. So anything don't involve no woman, it ain't good. I wonder, was he looking at him? Whatever it was, it wasn't good. Whether he was using his hand, whether it was two pumps or three pumps. Trying to get to no center, no tootsie roll pop. You can't do it. He saw the man, he said, it's not good. It ain't good for him to be by himself, because he's going to mess up. Yep. He sat around looking at all them elephants, everybody hanging, everybody that getting love, and he's sitting there, nobody. He said, not good. Whatever he's saying, then he said, not good. What was he doing? We know it wasn't good. Everything he made, he said, was good and very good. Now, why he saw the man, he saw somebody say, he said, ain't good. He don't need to be doing that by himself. He needs some help. Ain't that right? He need help. Some of y'all sitting here talking about you self-explanatory and self-made. You can't do that. You need some help. Yeah. I know some stuff outside your program. You can't do that. That time. What he was doing, you leave your imagination. But all I know, when he saw it, he said it wasn't good. Let go by the sheet. By our sheet. They gonna, oh, he shouldn't say that. I'm trying to help these young kids too, because soon they get a little, hey, they're gonna go playing with themselves. It ain't good. One and one. I used to be a teenager. I did all that stuff. We just ain't trying to act like y'all ain't did it. Or act like you ain't still doing it. Come on, one and one. Listen.
In Barashit, Elohim created Shamayim and the Aritz. And the Aritz was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Ruach of Elohim moved upon the face of the waters. And Elohim said, let there be light. And there was light. And Elohim saw the light, that it was good. And Elohim divided the light from the darkness. And Elohim called the light Yum, and the darkness he called night. And the evening and the morning were Akkad.
What happened?
And Elohim said, let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters.
Yeah.
And Elohim made the firmament and divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament. And it was so. And Elohim called the firmament Shamayim. And the evening and the morning were Shani. And Elohim said, let the waters under Shamayim be gathered together unto one place, and let the dry land appear. And it was so. And Elohim called the dry land Aritz.
Hold you got, hold you got. Got my mind running now. Back me back up to knock. I mean, back me back up. You gonna hold that? Get me Nakum Yah 8:1. Other brother gonna get me. Couldn't it, man. My mind went to run. Y'all going to work with me today. We're going to be kind of a little here, a little down. As Yahshua Yahu said. When I start hearing stuff, though, you know what I'm saying? I hear things. 27:41. We'll touch this and come back. Let's see what happened. You back me back up at that one and about, I think three. Let's see that first. Nakumiah 8:1. Listen.
And all the people gathered themselves together as one man into the street that was before the water gate.
Why?
And they spake unto Azara the scribe to bring the book of the law of Moshe, which Yahuwah had commanded to Yasharal. And Azara the Kohan brought the law before the congregation, both of men and women, and all that could hear with understanding upon the first yom of the seventh moon. Mm-hmm. And he read therein before the street that was before the water gate from the morning until mid yom before the men and the women and those that could understand, and the ears of all the people were attentive unto the book of the law.
What happened?
And Azara, the scribe, stood upon a pulpit of wood.
He did what?
Stood upon a pulpit of wood.
Tell him why.
Which they had made for the purpose. And beside him stood Mattathiah and Shema and Ananiah and Urijah and Hilkiah and Maaseiah on his right hand, and on his left hand Pedaiah and Mishael and Melchiah and Hashum and Hashbadanah and Zechariah and Meshulam. And Azara opened the book in the sight of all people, for he was above all the people.
Where was he at?
For he was above all the people.
At the Matthew Yahoo 27:41. Listen.
Likewise also, the chief Kohan mocking him with the scribes and elders said,
what they say?
He saved others.
Him who?
Himself he cannot save.
What they want him to do?
If he be the Malak of Yasharal.
Tell them what they want him to do.
Let him now come down from the cross.
And what happened?
And we will believe him.
What happened?
He trusted in Elohim.
Yes.
Let him deliver him now.
Uh-huh.
If he will have him.
Yeah.
For he said, I am the Ben of Elohim.
Yeah.
The thieves also, which were crucified with him.
Did what?
Cast the same in his teeth.
Yeah.
Now from the sixth hour.
That's good. At the book of Kazum, chapter 17, verse 11. You're going back to the book of Barashit, chapter 1. And about verse 2 will be fine. 3 come to mind. Let's see what 2 says. Kazum, chapter 17, at verse 11. Listen.
And the beast that was and is not, even he is the eighth.
Yeah.
And is of the seven and goeth into perdition.
What happened?
And the 10 horns which thou sawest are 10 Malakim, which have received no kingdom as yet, but receive power as Malakim 1 hour with the beast.
Yeah.
These have one mind and shall give their power and strength unto the beast. These shall make war with the Lamb, and the Lamb shall overcome them, for he is ruler of rulers and Malak of Malakim, and they that are with him are called and chosen and faithful.
What happened?
And he saith unto me, the waters which thou sawest.
The who?
The waters which thou sawest.
The waters. Uh-huh.
Where the whore sitteth are peoples and multitudes and nations and tongues, and the 10 horns which thou sawest upon the beast, these shall hate the whore, and shall make her desolate, and Ara, and shall eat her flesh, and burn her with fire, for Elohim hath put in their hearts to fulfill his will, and to agree, and give their kingdom unto the beast, until the words of Elohim shall be fulfilled, and the woman which thou sawest is that great city which reigneth over the Malakim of the Arits.
Listen, he kind of went a little further than I wanted, but that's fine at the same time. See if that's Yashayahu chapter 59. Why am I thinking 62? See if it's 59. What's the last verse of 59? Let me hear 21.
21.
21 is the last verse?
Yes, sir.
62. 62, what's the last verse, 62? 12, no. 16. When the enemy shall come in like a flood. What I want, 60? 15, 17. What I want, 60? Let me have 59:14. What I want, 59:19. 59? Oh, thank you, Bishop. 59, give me 17. Listen.
For he put on Sadiq as a breastplate
and
a helmet of salvation upon his head.
Yes.
And he put on the garments of vengeance for clothing.
Yes.
And was clad with zeal as a cloak.
What happened?
According to their deeds, accordingly he will repay.
To who?
Fury to his adversaries.
And what else?
Recompense to his enemies.
What happened?
To the islands he will repay recompense.
Y'all hear what he's going to do? To the coastlands he going to repay. Listen.
So shall they fear the name of Yahuwah from the west.
From what else?
And his glory from the rising of the sun.
And where does the sun rise at? In the east. Listen.
When the enemy shall come in like a flood.
The what happened?
The Ruach of Yahuwah shall lift up a standard against him.
The reason why I took y'all back here, look again at Bereshit chapter 1, chapter 2. Kind of like we went all the way around the place. Something hit my mind, so I said, well, let me just run right quick and say this to make a little sense. Bereshit 1 and 2. Listen.
And the Aritz was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep.
And what happened?
And the Ruach of Elohim moved upon the face of the waters, and Elohim said, let there be light, and there was light.
The reason why I took y'all back over here and I took y'all there apart, because it's the same thing he did. It didn't actually move, it hovered, it stayed right over the face of the water. That's what Azariah did. He sat upon a poor pit of wood. It told you he was above the people. The people represented the waters. That's why I took you to Kazun to tell you. We start telling you about the mystery, the water. He said, where the horse sit, the water. He said, that's actually people. That's what he was showing you. He actually declared the end at the beginning. Because he told you the thing concerning me. So when he told you about when you went to Bereshit, you shouldn't believe it. You didn't believe Bereshit. You think about moving, he was going. No, he actually was hovering. Right there, right above the people. That's the same thing he did here and the same thing he did down. That's why they told him to come down. Guess where he was? According to Nakum Yah, he was above the people. The pulpit of wood put him above the people. So did the toot for him. It also tied him in to be able to do exactly what happened by the sheep. He was hovering above the people. Oh, I'm sorry, above the waters. Amen. That's why he told you that when the enemy shall come in, what was the word? Like, similar. Like a flood. He told you that the standard, the spirit was going to lift up a standard. That's how he got up there. Above, against them. That's what he did. Man. Listen to what else happened. About a sheep.
And Elohim saw the light, that it was good, and Elohim divided the light from the darkness.
So when he saw the sun up there, he said it was good. The sun producing light. Let's see what the book said. Pick me up the book of Zechariah. Now, I was going a whole nother way, but when you start listening, stuff spark you. Zechariah. Fourteen and six. Let's see if it makes sense. Y'all all right?
Amen.
Listen.
And it shall come to pass in that yom.
Y'all pay attention. It's going to come to pass in that yom. What happened?
That the light shall not be clear.
Y'all hear this? If the light ain't going to be clear, it's going to be dark. What happened?
Nor dark.
Nor is it going to be dark. Tell them what's going to happen.
But it shall be one yom which shall be known to Yahuwah.
Listen what happened. Now. It's going to be one yom that's going to be known with Yahuwah. Tell them what's going to happen.
Not yom nor night.
Y'all hear this? It's not going to be light or it's going to be dark. But tell them what's going to happen.
But it shall come to pass.
That at what happened?
At evening time.
Tell them what's going to happen.
It shall be light.
Back at Bereshit 1 and 1. 1 and 2. Matter of fact, make it 1 and 1. You don't have to say in. You just go Bereshit. Because Bereshit going to be the start. Bereshit.
Elohim created the Shamayim and the Aritz.
And tell them what happened.
And the Aritz was without form.
And what else was it?
Void.
Tell them what happened.
And darkness was upon the face of the deep.
And tell them what happened.
The Ruach of Elohim moved upon the face of the
and
waters.
And hovered right above the face of the waters. And tell them what else happened, son.
And Elohim said,
"What let that do what?
Be light."
That's how we know the sun. He couldn't actually be the sun if he wasn't light. Listen what happened.
And there was light.
So listen what happened.
And Elohim saw the light.
And that it was what?
Good.
He told you, this is my beloved son, in whom I'm well pleased. Good. Listen, what else he told you?
And Elohim divided the light from the darkness.
He divided the light from the darkness. And you know what else happened? That's why he had him up on the two, and that's why you were down below. He was dividing the light from the darkness.
Amen.
That's why he was hovering above it. He told you that darkness was upon the face of the deep. It ain't where I was at. That's why I was hovering. They missed it. Listen, what else happened?
And Elohim called the light Yom.
And what else happened?
The darkness he called night.
And listen what happened.
And the evening and the morning.
What a what?
First Yom.
That's what Zechariah just told you. He said it was going to be one Yom that was going to be known to him. And matter of fact, at evening time, it was light. A card. First day of your week, which is going to be first. For what they're going to call Sunday, which is Greek. A card. See, what Zechariah told you, you shouldn't have believed him. You didn't believe by the sheep. One, as they say, day that's going to be known to him. How you going to forget by the sheep? That's the start. One day, and then it was evening time. He just told you it was dark, and he said, let it be light. It's a lot they miss. A lot y'all miss. Listen what else he told them.
And Elohim said, let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters.
You know what happened? That's the same thing happened with us. Something came up in the middle that separated us. Listen.
And Elohim made the firmament and divided the waters which were under the firmament.
Y'all hear me there? He made a firmament that divided the firmament from where?
And Elohim made the firmament and divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament.
Yeah.
And it was so.
What else happened?
And Elohim called the firmament Shamayim.
You give me Tahalim 50 and 5. Tahalim. Praises. Listen. Hold that. Matter of fact, go ahead and give me that Tahalim 50 and 5. Tell them what he said, Brandon.
Gather my saints together unto me.
Those that did what?
Have made a covenant with me.
By what?
Sacrifice.
What does he want to happen?
And the Shamayim shall declare.
And the
Shamayim
shall do what?
Declare his Sadiq.
Let's jump back over to the book of Bereshit, chapter 1. What verse we at? 5?
8.
At verse 8. Listen what happened.
And Elohim called the firmament Shamayim.
Yeah.
And the evening and the morning were the Shani Yom.
Which is going to be the second. Shani. For what they're going to call, this is what you're going to call Monday. And we're about to run out now because you're going to make me start using up my English. They're going to mess up my Abari now. Go ahead.
And Elohim said, let the waters under the Shamayim.
This is what he told him. Let the who?
Waters under the Shamayim.
Do what?
Be gathered together.
I don't know. I couldn't imagine where he wanted to be gathered at.
Unto one place.
That's how we're going back to Jerusalem. Again, he tried to tell you, I declared the end at the beginning. That's the only way it made sense. First of all, I had to disperse all of it. So I brought up the writs and made it separate all of them. Then I say, you know what? Gather it all together into one place. So when you heard Tahalim, you shouldn't believe unless you believe by the sheep. Gather my saints together. Remember the water with people.
Right.
Those that made a covenant with me by sacrifice. You know who's going to declare it? The Shamayim.
Yeah.
That's how quick he moved. Yeah. Only man can be sitting still and yet be performing. Ain't it beautiful?
Yes, sir.
That's a beautiful walk. If people just sat down and considered the man way, you'll never get enough of this. He always got something he can come back and feed you and try to show you. At the book of Yehukanan, chapter 6 and verse 44. That's why I told y'all I need y'all to get conscious, because there's too much y'all don't know. There's a lot you'll think you know, but you really don't know it. You just thought, you just read what, 8-9 verses, and you didn't know that one, that much was in 8 or 9 verses. Because when we look, what you see? You see it from a kind of perspective. So that's what we got to try to look, and we got to try to make sure we get a grasp, of understanding. Other brother, you going to get me the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15? I know we were going on about Adam. Before the rain, we talk about that too much, I guess, with y'all right now. Like I said, we can't particularly speak about that this time. But that's the truth, though. Whatever he was doing, it wasn't good. And I was sure, and I still prove that out because he just showed you. Before you get me that where I'm going, pick me up at Bereshit chapter 2, at verse 18. Listen, I'm going to give me 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 30, make it 33, it's the same word. Listen, I'll read now. Listen.
And Elohim said, it is not good.
Back me up at verse 16. Listen.
And Elohim commanded the Anus, saying, of every tree of the garden thou mayest freely eat, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil thou shalt not eat of it, for in the womb that thou eatest thereof thou shalt surely die.
Yes.
And Elohim said, it is not good that the Anus should be alone. I will make him and help meet for him.
So we're going to look at this and try to consider everything he made. He said was good. Everything beginning, everything by the sheet, all the way down, every one of the humans he declared were good. Everything was done. But after he created all of the, when he created the creatures, he said he brought back and realized when it come down to the man, this ain't good. I said that to cover more than one area with y'all. A lot of stuff y'all do is not good. It's not good. You need somebody to help you do that. That's not in your occupation. That's outside of your job description for you to do it. Y'all hear me? I know I got these kids. Same thing with these little kids. I know they're going to want to practice because their friends going to tell them. That's how I got in all that stuff, that masturbating friend. Man, you know how to ejaculate. You know how that? Y'all need to do that. It's not good. He saw the man. He said it's not good. Amen. You need a woman to help you do that. And that woman you need to get need to be your wife. Amen. These kids ain't stupid. A lot of y'all, but he shouldn't tell these kids no more than y'all know and watch more than what y'all know. These kids got a telephone, show them everything they need to see. Yep. Have I said anything y'all don't know? I don't look at these kids, they like, nope. I mean, they're being honest. I ain't trying, just being honest. Have I said something y'all didn't know? The kid know a whole lot more. We be sitting around, I thought my kid was stupid. Kid know a whole lot more what y'all know. We like to think, just like our parents, you be thinking, they don't know none of them kids. Kid don't know a whole lot more. They in school around them son of kids. I remember in the fifth grade, kid brought a rubber skate. Ain't know what that thing was. Talking about a raincoat. I was looking, trying to put on something to stop water. This man said, a raincoat. Yeah, he said, I'm like, what? A rubber? Yeah. Ain't know what a rubber was. Like, what in the world, a rubber? Yeah. We ain't called it, honey. How many of y'all call a rubber? Yeah. They call it a raincoat. They had older brother gave them. They brought them to school to show up. You know what that led to? Yeah. Them joking in the bathroom, put them on, ain't got nothing to keep, ain't got nothing to worry about getting wet. Well, you would have left that in the done packet. Because a whole lot of these older folk come introducing these young folk to stuff. Y'all watch a lot of these older brothers, sitting these uncles and aunts and everybody else. They get a lot of them out here in the done sex trade. And they be sitting around being stupid and gubble. These kids need to know. We losing two and two minutes. Your hand ain't got no bending down there either. When you ain't washing, get it out of there. Your hand ain't no doing Kotex. Around that done, it's no good way you go in that vegetable aisle. Get away from them done cucumbers. Don't mess your done stuff up. No good way you ain't gonna be no yellow squash. Give Brandon demerit for thinking about a yellow squash. Give him a demerit. And I gotta teach our people. Let me tell you the truth about it. You know what our problem is? Nobody ever been real with us. No good done well. Y'all, everybody here know done good done practice it. Don't try to act like y'all done stupid. These kids ain't stupid. That's what's wrong there. You sit in church for like they talk around the kid. Kids just be sitting there like, okay, you hear what you think? Say, let me pull this phone. I can show you more than what you know. You're behind, so we so old and outdated, these kids way more advanced. Now I'm gonna look at Antoine, look around. Have I said something you didn't know? I'm trying to tell y'all, ain't no need, ain't trying to get no in trouble, just being honest. And that's why kids will keep going. We be sitting around gullible and stupid. They ain't even think about sex. You ain't got that little pickle not to be doing nothing with it.
That's right.
That pickle want to be tickle.
That's right.
Same thing with a girl. You think that man gave you a glove and you ain't trying to catch no balls? I'm going to go buy my kid a baseball glove and he don't even want to catch no balls. That don't make no sense again. No bat, no glove. Isn't that right? I don't tell them the truth, though. You need to be married.
Yep.
Tell them the truth. You need, if you're not, you'll commit fornication.
Yep.
And you can't be doing loving yourself.
Yep.
You know that area suck? So throw water and soap down the attic. Can't rub too hard. I'm not telling you, I'm trying to make sure it's clean. No, it ain't. All right, stop it. I know these jokes, they ain't fooling me. Where that shampoo? No, ain't no done shampoo. Straighten y'all behind up in here. But I said it because somebody been fumbling around.
Yeah.
Ain't no fool watching out there too. And a lot of these folks, yeah, it's hard on you. It's, you know why I like that? It's supposed to be like that. Because it told you, it ain't good for you to be by yourself.
Right.
You know, I got to get myself together. If you putting that peck in your hand, making your own lotion, your own shampoo, you need to be together. You need a why. You, why I don't and say, man, I get myself, I get a job. I try to get right, try to get a car. Hey, man, like, man, I got to get moving. I've been waiting on this. That joke, soon he got that joke, said, mine. He playing sweat. When he got up, that joke came through and said, mine. Man, I seen two pieces of fat with buttons on them. That mine. That ain't crazy. He's like, what it did? Who it did? I don't know what. I know exactly what to do. Man, to go to no sex class.
Right.
Isn't that right? He saw the glove. He's humping the pitch. Batter up. Y'all be crazy. And get Waju and Tommy a demerit. Waju, because he was smiling. Tommy, because he don't know why he was smiling. Isn't that right? Get both of them a demerit, too. That's just being honest. I want these young folk to know the truth. Y'all need to be married.
Yeah.
Don't be fumbling around with yourself. It's not good.
Yeah.
It's not good. Let them know it's wrong. They help the grown. I need to help the grown folk too. Y'all gonna reach your age, you're gonna get horny, all that old stuff. No, get you, wait till you get an age, get mature. Sex is for people that mature. Married. Well, sit around here, white folks come in and made a done mess, been making baby, ain't married, then got these kids, then the kids suffer, you suffer, why you gonna leave out and go make some more? That's stupid. That's straight right there, you're immature, it ain't for you.
Right.
You irresponsible.
Yeah.
You wanna have sex, you need to be responsible, meaning you need a wife.
Yeah.
Isn't that right?
Yeah.
So ain't make no fool out of you. Come on, son, give me that 1 Corinthians 7:1 while I'm over here. You know, all right, I'm gonna hit it. I got a call, who know why I call it? Because it's right. Help these young folks. So I get to preaching all this other stuff going. These folks think I got soft on sin. That's why everybody's so comfortable around here. Ain't got no business being doing comfortable. Get you a done wife. Get you a husband. You want somebody to hold your titty, touch your button, get you a husband. Your boyfriend ain't got no business with your button in his mouth. You play that button, who got the button? Need to be the husband. I'll be honest with you, boy. When you think about a button that can make 5 pounds of fat look better, a button, that button is important. Man, that button, you think about like some of these ugly folks, I wonder how they look if you put a button in their forehead. I mean, just then you had the power. You think about it, though. You got from some ounces to possibly 5 pounds of fat, not one muscle in it. And all you gotta do is put a button on that thing. You throwing some of these ugly folk. If I could walk around and just put a button on people, just seeing a fella just put a button right in the middle of their forehead. Then you just squeeze their forehead and walk off. Man, that word probably, man, it'd probably be somewhere at peace. It'd be somewhere at peace around here and harmony. Y'all remember that song? I like to buy the world a Coke. Y'all remember they had a Coke? I just like to buy the world a button. So you just learn harmony. All right, let's keep moving. Y'all know sometimes not myself. Go ahead. I like shower, whether in the body or out of the body, I cannot tell. Listen.
Now concerning the things whereof you wrote unto me.
It is what? It's okay?
It is good.
For a man.
Not to touch
well,
a woman.
Well, we're going to say a noose.
For a noose, not to touch a neshim.
That's right. Nevertheless.
To avoid fornication.
Let every who.
A noose.
Have his who.
Own.
I'm going to get my own pistol. I'm about to. Don't make me open up your head. Just read that thing. Have his own what?
Wife.
Neshim. Every anus have his own neshim. Let me break this up. I'm going to go to jail. Just before I go, though. A noose for man, right? I touch him. Wife, don't like that. Y'all got that? I'll come back to that. I'm correct. Maybe I need to erase that whole thing and to do it over. Or person. Y'all got that? A noose can be for person too. That's good. So I'm saying I gotta erase the whole thing and come back and write it better. Y'all got it?
Amen.
Neshim can be for wife, female, I'm sorry, woman, female, wife. A noose can be for man, mortal man, or person. Y'all got it? Y'all know a lot of places y'all going off wasted kind of time with y'all. Them camps, y'all. How many of y'all come out of them camps? How many of them camps you to write down stuff? And just throw stuff out of there. We try to make sure y'all learn so y'all can kind of comprehend. Y'all got that? So we want to make sure that every anus get his own neshim to avoid that. So when we start playing around any other way, we look at transgression. So when he saw the man in the garden, that became a law for us. It's not good for a man to be by himself. That man need to get him a neshim. Y'all got me? And whether we take it as a small thing or not, that's what you need. If y'all in here playing with yourself, other than this camera, wherever y'all at, playing with yourself, you need to get your neshim. Men, if a noose, neshim, you know what you need to get? If you're in there playing and you sitting around here getting them cucumbers, half and half, you need to cut it off. You need to get you a noose. Y'all got me? I'm being honest. I don't know how y'all saying. I know you're horny. I don't know what y'all wearing. You're horny. So that joke look like a done bull rush thing coming out. Come outside here. What you doing? You know you're horny. What y'all waiting on? I don't get it. Do like Eric, man. Go there, fly with the mechanic clothes and go get you one. That joke went on that. That's what I'm talking. That joke was. Listen, he mechanic from down here. He warrior up top. That joke got a. He got a Battlestar Galactica. What that green that army fatigue shirt? I ain't seen a damn military. With his mechanic pants and his boot. That just. That joke in the jungle like that. 100 to death. He couldn't stand like this. That just stand like this. 100 to death. Man, you can't take, man, let me tell you something. Even charging got, he got Jane pregnant in the jungle. You can't be in no jungle with no one by yourself. Don't y'all know bears do it in the woods? How many bears y'all seen have sex in the spreadway? They do it in the woods. Good Solomon the mayor. They ain't got no hotel. They ain't got no RV. I'm trying to help y'all out. Y'all got to, I want to be honest with y'all. I want y'all to get this right. Everybody here, don't be sitting around and keep playing with yourself now. Yeah. Trying to look around just say, Leon said, he don't want nobody. Yeah, me neither. I don't want nobody. Man, no good and doing well. Better get you doing somebody. You know some of y'all going to have to pay, but we gave dowry before. Some of y'all going to overpay. You can call it a dowry for, isn't that right? Some of y'all are going to be like $20,000. Work hard. Some of the call it a dowry. It ain't about no hoe. You just pay the dowry. Some of y'all had to pay. That's been honest. Some of y'all had to pay. Or get you a button and put it in the middle of your forehead or something. But anyway, the moral of the story is this won't deter from early voting. That's what everybody remember. It would not deter for November the 8th. Please go to your poll. No, stop. Do not go to the poll. Do not abort. Do not go to the poll November the 8th. Yeah, right. Go to Neshim. Now, look at something else. Pick me up at 1 Corinthians 15:33. Y'all off the chain. Only here I get in trouble. This is 15:33. Listen, be not deceived.
Evil communications.
Corrupt what?
Good manners.
Awake to what?
To Sadiq.
And sin what?
Not.
See that? Y'all see him playing around with that thing? Just like the women. You can't push your own button. I'm being honest with y'all. You can't play around. I'm trying to tell y'all now. And we got some people tell you they married and separated, so that's a different protocol. But you talking about a lot of y'all sitting here and singing, I don't know what him, I'm just like the unit. What does him to you? Especially when you see it right there. What does, he looked at what he want to get back to, he like, emergency. He look at, he go, water, what's hindering me? I'm trying to figure out with y'all, Joker, what hindered you? Okay, I can't tell them lying now. I keep lying. Man, that's a beautiful way you do it right with the right person. I'm just being honest with you now. He's trying to tell you, evil communication, corrupt good manner. Await the Sadiq and sin not, because you won't be sinning now. Y'all right now playing with the done pickle, right now pushing the button. And told you, but await the righteous, await the Sadiq and sin not, for some have not the knowledge of who?
Of Elohim.
See, that's what you got to be careful of. Being ignorant, you're going about to establish your own right. And won't submit yourself to the Sadiq of him. No, you want something, then y'all like window shopping. If I showed you one, found one for him, I'd go, sometimes I say, I said, you want a straight man? Ain't gay, ain't slept with Magic Johnson. They be kick. I said, I ain't playing. I said, hey, you want somebody? I said, come here for a minute. They'll come here, I tell them. I said, come here. I said, if I told you I ain't gay, I ain't finna be touching, you ain't gonna touch me, and this is what I do, they said, I could do that. I said, I know I got a strong disposition. But you gotta know how to overshadow. I do like Yahuwah. When he come in, you overshadow. Yeah. You don't come in, you gonna come under. No, she ain't gonna do it.
you gonna want.
She's like, no, nigga, I ain't. Why you ask, nigga? They know, nigga, look at me and tell us that nigga, he'll knock me out. You gotta go to somebody strong. Woman want a man comfort, ain't it? Am I correct, women? They don't want a man sure and say, you right up pecking around talking about what she ain't gonna want. Hey, that's a what she want. I'm telling her. This is what I'm gonna tell you. This is what we're gonna do. I'm gonna say, I can help these guys, they ain't gonna do it. I go sell right down on Mr. Button. They ain't gonna do nothing. They gonna be tripping. They naked. I tell y'all all the time, even these women here, y'all realize just what kind of extra power y'all have. I don't know why y'all did. Don't I want with this cup? You right, it nasty, it stink, wash it. You fix yourself, I'm carrying. These men are sitting here, they see quality when they see it. Yep. They see holes all day long. I get y'all here and get y'all think, oh, he be trying. You put yourself together. You don't cut your Mitch Mac, your stuff don't fit, your done look sloppy, your headscarf stink in your head napping. Nobody want you. You don't even want you. Right. You try to go around your head, I ain't gonna do that. Now, what you think somebody gonna do with it? Man, honey, y'all put yourself together and dress yourself up and care of yourself. These men are saying he can see you. Why ain't talking about a bird? Listen, You see hoes all the time.
All the time.
Right, see, you stick out here, head cups, saying, trap, man, nigga said something different, but they already know the guy. Come here, little shawty, come here, little hoe. They see y'all already know. Can't approach y'all like that. They be like, they don't come because they already realize my conversation for hoes, you don't look like a hoe.
Right.
And first thing I want to do, you want to hoe it up. I better roll. Mother didn't want me to look all, I got to roll up. Now you finna get this shawty in the whole holler. Because you see, you looking just like them. You just done wrapped your head up because you too lazy to comb it. Now, no, you got that on your head as a symbol of authority. Everybody see them in jeans. Everybody done got on jeans. All the way, what puts you different than them?
Right.
Now you got to get something tighter. Now you don't get a yeast infection. Yep. Now you done mess around. You got to go get some more messing gear. Yep. Sit in here, you smell like a done deal pickle. Smell like pickle done pick. Get Matthew, get him a demerit. I don't think about eating deal pickle for some reason. I'm just being honest with y'all. You gotta be different. Y'all can't try to fit in with these people. That's what he told you. Don't be not deceived. Evil communication corrupt good manners. You supposed to wait the Sadiq and say not. These people ain't got no knowledge. When they stuff get through, they ain't no man putting you on your back early, thinking later, making you know why. They already look at you. I already got it. I can get that anytime. He going out of what he can't get. You know that nigga the same like Richard Dipp song years ago? She's got papers on me. Y'all remember that? She's got papers. Y'all don't remember that Richard Dipp song? When he was sleeping with the woman, he had to leave. He was trying to leave. The woman was trying to get him to stay with her. He told her why he got papers on him. He can't leave. You didn't. That was like early 90s. Y'all don't remember She Got Papers? Who remember? You remember that, don't you, CJ? Y'all remember, I'm telling you, y'all remember that was Siri Bad. Who else remember? Don't you remember that song years ago? It was way back. That thing was bad. Y'all took the wrong way back. 1979. Y'all took the wrong way back. I still got tickets from the championship back then. But no, that was, the moral of what I was trying to say, don't look at what he did, but I was just trying to show you. The song was about he was out with his woman. She wanted him to stay there with him. And he was telling he had to go home because his wife had papers on him. He couldn't stay there. Now the song was called She Got Papers on Me. I can't stay him. I'm telling you, you need to get papers on that nigga. Anybody going to be committed when they getting no draws, ain't got no papers? I've been trying to hook y'all and trying to tell. Don't let nobody make no fool out of you. One time, two times, you're going to be hit all the time. Then you'll get hit some more. Then you get stuck left with these kids. These y'all gonna be gone. Now these women, you got one kid in hard enough, you get 2, 3, 5 of them, you're done. Oh, you finna be a target practice. You might as well go to the gun range. They're unloading you. Y'all know I'm telling the truth. It's hard out here. I be trying to help. Y'all got opportunity to make a whole lot of better sense. Y'all can keep thinking, you got to do what these women do to fit in with these women. I'm trying to tell you, these women play out. These guys like me, I played in them streets. I was out there hard. I was out in them streets. That boy ain't been nowhere. How about that mean? 900,923 more of them things, baby. I was out there hard in them streets. I didn't that sound like all the wet streets was you in. You know, down at school, I was selling them snacks. I mean, I was selling crack. I'm just saying, though, when I got that dinner, I shacked up. I thought I lived about 6 women. I lived probably about 6 something. Let me tell you something. I wasn't married none of them helpers. They didn't have me. I wasn't married none. We had a good time. I lived with them, pay bills, let you ride, you can drive the car, all that good stuff. Kept them helper head fit. Wasn't finna marry them, though. I'm a good time girl. I was a dope man. You go out, you want something on your arm like that. Isn't that right? Man, y'all just tell you something. Y'all just don't know. Boy, I was sitting on some kind of pretty too, boy. God almighty. Woo! Boy, I was doing that thing. I know a lot of them ain't done that. They ain't done. I know a lot of them ain't done. Don't worry about it. Don't try to get yourself out of there. It's too late now. Don't try to. You ain't gonna be able to do it. You've been spending a whole lot of money. I was out there for free. You know what I'm saying? $5. Chat and blame it. You spend $5 on a $300 trick, blame it. Y'all still blame it. Don't mess yourself up now. I'm trying to tell you, I've been out there in them streets. My wife said, I need to go to bed. I can't, look at him. I keep one on the side. They know they were right there. They come. They got to come get with me. Y'all hear him? He said, you want to see? They had to get with me. Before I meet marijuana, no. I got me an easy old little country girl over there. Taught her how to wear a shoe. Taught her how to, she's like, I just calm down. She was excited. Listen, I'm driving a Porsche, jeweled up, cut up, all my stuff matching. She knew that was way higher than she was supposed to be. Listen, I gave her a ride home. She said, there's a post. I got a post. How did I do? I said, calm down. You loud in my radio. Calm down. I got amps. We're like, calm down. Boy, she was so excited, boy, she didn't know what to do. Took out that a Ben and Hunter, took it out of that way higher than she done been. Shot it down there. She lit it, got celebrity all on the wall and took it out now. They'll dunk that. They'll weigh the food on the top. I said, calm down. Calm out. Leon, I said, I'll get this little cunt. She's so easy. Oh. Poor thing ain't been nowhere. She done thought the folk done dunked the food. They'll weigh the food. We ain't gonna pay for it. Calm down. Let the man do his job. I got you. Man, she had been wet. Listen, she was high and lifted up. I took away, she had been, you'd have been that high. She told them all, she said, man, they were saying, that boy not gonna marry. You done seen them women, all of them, that boy done had. Yeah, she'll tell them all. They were like, no, not him. Listen, she'll tell them, they to bring their daughter to meet. Listen, I could, there they come. Mama comes and listen, they're my daughter right here. I want to meet you. I said, y'all know your daughter. She like, you know him, you need to get with him. I like, I got somebody already. You know what their mama said? So, you ain't married. They mommy, and they knew I was selling dope. But I was showing her looking good, though. But God almighty. Woo, how so black like they painted it. Woo, you know that the mama bring them to the drug, I told her. I said, I'm living with somebody. Their mama tell me they didn't care. They said, he not married. I'm just looking. You gonna give me your daughter? That girl's so excited, but she got choked. She's still excited now. I said, I gotta be still asleep. She said, give me a pull, put it. He don't let it be a dream. But he here for real. I just, I'm gonna be like. She be so excited. I just be like, calm down. And y'all, Aaron, I be like, calm down. You know what I'm saying? She knew she went way above her, but it can't have nothing. But she done rolled out in the port like that. Woo, done snapped. Woo, woo. High and lifted up. And a train filled the tune. Boy, she was high. So I'm trying to tell y'all, take your time. You don't know what you'll get. You don't know what blessing might bestow upon you. Take your time. Y'all be running all ahead and going backward. Look at these trick holes and all this stuff. Take your time. I'm telling you, because you know what happened? When you get through out in the street, mess around, I'm like, man, you want none of them girls like that. We was out there with good timing. I'm for the, I like L, drink L Green, for the good time. Lay your head. That's all. All right. I heard my background back there. And went way back there. I'm just saying, when you get ready, man, you want a wife. You're trying to get somebody a little wholesome. I can get out there been slinging no dope now. No. Isn't that right? I'm trying to help them out. A lot of times y'all trying to ride up. Let them little things go and play out there. Let them keep on getting up. You'll see out a while, they're going to be fat, nasty, bloated, burnt out. They're going to be sitting right there. Nah, I ain't trying to marry you. I'm trying to get me somebody else. I'm trying to tell y'all now. I can help y'all out. You hearing it from a man. You talking about who seen TV, who wasn't doing that with something. Some of these jokes, I wouldn't let nothing they going to say. That's how many I had. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wow. And all of them right here. All right, I'm trying to tell you now. I ain't lying about my stuff. I know the joke. I'm going to be lying now. I just be listening, folks. I ain't lying. You ask somebody about me, I was out there hard in them streets. Y'all hear me? I wasn't no window shopper. And I wasn't out there buying no hoes either now. So he call it a diary. Oh, now they called buying hoes. Time to tell, a real man get ready to set out, he gonna be looking for a wife. Something wholesome, something keep a house, something he can make kids with, something he can trust. Can't marry them streetwalkers. So y'all take it to heart now. It'll pay off for you. Come on, son, finish that 1 Corinthians 15. Trying to help him out there, ain't it? Listen.
For some have not the knowledge of Elohim.
Y'all hear that? Some have not the knowledge of Elohim. What happened?
I speak this to your shame.
Listen.
But some, Anus, will say, how are the dead raised up?
Yes.
And with what body do they come?
What happened?
Thou fool, that which thou sowest is not quickened except it die.
Y'all hear what happened? That which you soweth is not going to be made alive unless it die. That's the purpose of us being husbandmen, as they would call it, being farmers, because we should know this. A lot of the concept of what we hear through the law and through the epistle letters come through, a lot of it comes through our actual experience. Anybody know anything about planting seed? Those seeds are not alive, they got to die. Go take a watermelon seed. As soon as you eat a watermelon, take that seed and put it in the ground and see what it'll do. It won't die. It's got to dry out. That's the same thing we did with Yahusha. That's why they put him on the tube. And guess what he didn't do? Pick me up at 27. Matthew Yahoo 27. Matthew Yahoo 27. Listen.
And they spit upon him and took the reed and smote him on the head.
Listen.
And after that they had mocked him, they took the robe off from him and put his own raiment on him and led him away to crucify him.
Back me up, make it 27. Listen.
Then the soldiers of the governor took Yahusha into the common hall and gathered unto him the whole band of soldiers, and they stripped him and put on him a scarlet robe. And when they had plaited a crown of thorns, they put it upon his head and a reed in his right hand, and they bowed the knee before him and mocked him, saying, Hail, Malach of the Yahudim! And they spit upon him and took the reed and smote him on the head. And after that they had mocked him, they took the robe off from him and put his own raiment on him and led him away to crucify him.
Come on.
And as they came out, they found a man of Cyrene, Shimon by name. Him they compelled to bear his cross. And when they were come unto a place called Golgotha, that is to say, a place of a skull, they gave him vinegar to drink.
They gave him what?
Vinegar to drink.
Mm-hmm.
Mingled with gall.
Tell them what happened.
And when he had tasted thereof.
When he did what?
Had tasted thereof.
Tell them what has happened.
He would not drink.
Y'all hear that? He wouldn't drink it. Because you know what a seed got to do? It's got to die. It's got to dry out. That's what's got to happen. It's got to die out. It's got to dry out. Go take any seed from any fruit. Go take a peach seed. As soon as you get filled with, go plant a ground seed for the die. It's got to dry out. That's what he knew. Listen to his own statement. Yehukanan 12:21. That's why we need to get back to farming. So you'll understand a lot of these concepts. Season, times. That's why he said a time and season. Aki, you have no need I shall write unto you. Because you're going to know. Right? We were given how to tell our time. What we put to you? The sun, the moon. Isn't that right? So this is the same thing we're supposed to use now. That's why, and then with the fact that when we harvest, when it's time to plant, then you need to know something about seed. The same thing with us. When he told us, having therefore these promises dearly beloved, let us do what? From all what? Of the what? And what else? That's right, got to get rid of everything. Dry out. That's amazing. When a person go to Alcoholics Anonymous, when they go to the camp, what do they go there to do? They call it the dry out. That's what they call it. You're drying out when you rehab. You got to dry out. In order for any change to happen, you got to dry out. See, they understand the concept. See, because you know what they learned? All these people learned. They take it from the book. They don't give you all Ahim. They give you higher power. But they show you that everybody know. Because our book said that every soul be subject to the high power. Isn't that right? A power, higher authority is all they're saying. The high authority is going to be him. That's why he would put it, he said, his servant going to be a stole, and he's going to be very what? He was a higher authority, higher power. Y'all got it? Listen.
The same came therefore to Philip, which was of Bethsaida of Galilee, and desired him, saying, Sir, we would see Yahusha.
What happened?
Philip cometh and telleth Andrew, and again Andrew and Philip tell Yahusha.
What happened?
And Yahusha answered them, saying, The hour is come that the Ben of Anus should be glorified.
Listen.
Verily, verily, I say unto you,
except
a corn of wheat fall into the ground and die.
What happened?
It abideth alone.
Which means he had to dry out. That's why he wouldn't drink. See, all this made sense. Everything started to make sense when you go back to start looking at pattern of behavior. When you're going to plant, you're not going to plant a wet seed. But guess what you're going to do once you put in the ground? Believe it or not, you're going to wind up watering it. Huh? That's what you're going to do. You're going to wind up watering that to get in. That's what would have got him right back up. We look at the Spirit coming down, showering, overcoming. Isn't that right? That's the same thing we started to look at. But first, you got to dry out. You don't wet a wet seed. You're going to wet a dry seed. That's the same thing we look at now, right? Except the corn of wheat fall into the ground and do what?
And die.
It doth what?
Abideth alone.
So you see, it's a necessity. We got to die. How you going to make it? That's why we got to submit. Come under subjection. Y'all hear me? From our own ways, our own mindset. I mean, you're going to have to die to the will of the flesh. If you don't, you're going to abide alone. Listen.
But if it die.
And doth what?
It bringeth forth much fruit.
Yes, and that's what we're looking at. That's only going to come abundant. A lot of times we don't see, it's imperative that we die. Isn't that right? Of the natural man as well as of the Ruach man. That's the only way you're going to gather in more. Y'all got it. Just like when you plant that watermelon seed, you look to get more than what you put in, right? Well, you're looking to get more than what you are now. The only way you're going to do that, you got to give up something. That's why a lot of people never obtain it. Look at what you got to give up. When he found the young man, he told him how to read the law. When he asked about being perfect, he said, all this I done kept since my youth up. What lack I yet? The only problem some of you got, you're going to have to get rid of some of the stuff you got. It wasn't the law. He already done it. Shabbat wasn't a problem. None of the judgment, none of the statutes were a problem. But where the problem came in? Get rid of what you got, and you can have treasure in Shamayim. First of all, I ain't trying to get nothing later. I'm trying to get everything I can get now. I know that's your problem. See, you know what the book said you have need of? Patience. When? After you've done the will. See, that's why a lot of people mess up here and they faint. If they don't get nothing immediately after they do something, that's amazing. But they'll go and invest and buy a CD. They'll pay off in 5 years. They'll go and start a retirement, get a job, and they got 30 years before they retire, 20 years. Then soon they come and serve him day, they won't all be. Who joined the military and you get 30-year retirement the first week? Rank, everything going to play a part of what you're going to get. Time you put in going to play a part of what you're going to get. Then why you think you're going to walk in and get the same thing everybody else get? Then you got to put your time. That means you're going to have some need of patience. After you've done the will of Elohim. And that's the mindset we get. But you know what shoots us and that condemns us in the last day? Because you'll sit here and you'll submit and you'll wait patiently for that. But you won't wait on reward from Shamayim. Come on back to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15. Hopefully I help somebody. Just looking at how a book just, it intertwines every perfect way for us. I say it's easy to get yourself entangled with these people out here. It's easy to get yourself entangled with trying to get and trying to have now. But you don't realize it's a day of judgment coming. Isn't that right? How many of y'all feel like you every time you learn like you're going through or you suffering for something? Or being paid back for something? Good. Because the book said judgment must begin here. And if it first began with us, what the end gonna be for the people to get it later? I'd rather get mine now. I don't want mine later. Amen. There's some people, when you look at people that always hitting again, you saying, why that couldn't be me? But then you don't think about it. They getting theirs in the end. Ain't that right? You know what the book told them? Then the beginning. When you start sitting big, when judgment comes, you want already been paid up. You don't want to wait to judgment and you still got some on the tab. Let me go ahead and suffer what I got to suffer. I had to lose a house now, move an apartment, and I can be saved. Ain't that right? I don't want to have a house all my life and go to hell and say, had you an apartment, you could have been saved. Huh? I could have been single, be by myself, and be saved. Then I could be married, be happy with a bunch of kids, and go to hell. Huh? All right. Even Shaluma told about that. A man live 100 years but get all them kids and don't have no joy, said untimely birth is better than him. All this stuff you be designed you want, said better for a stillborn baby to come in and got a better chance than you got. Say here you get all these years and obtain all this stuff, then later on you wind up dying and you wind up in misery and you wind up going to hell. Everybody here, you need to think about that. A lot of times you serve because he's trying to get you now versus getting you later. Listen.
Thou fool, that which thou sowest is not quickened except it die.
See that? So it makes sense when he told us that. except they die, it'll abide alone. He told you a fool, meaning you already knew this. If you're a husbandman, you've been planting, you already knew that seed had to die. Those are not living seeds in that in old packet. Those seeds are dead. So they can be planted so they can bring forth more fruit. One watermelon seed ain't going to bring another watermelon seed. It's going to bring a watermelon, which is going to be abundant in seeds. Well, that's the same thing with you. If you die and let go of your own will, you don't realize there's more to you than what you see. But some of y'all stuck with there being a seed. It makes no sense. That seed got to be put where it can multiply. Listen to the book.
And that which thou sowest not that body that shall be, but bare grain, it may chance of wheat or
what
some other grain.
What said that mate, though? I'm going to sit here, I'm going to let this die, to get up and it still be this. Then it only makes sense not to plant it. I'm going to give $5 to get $5. That don't even make sense. I keep the $5. The only thing that's going to be attractive to me to give you $5 is the gain of 6 or 10 or 12 or 20. Well, the gain of me saying dying, letting go of my life, has to be something greater. Some people die with the wrong concept. It makes no sense to plant and pick up the same thing you put down. Plant a seed, pick a seed back up later, the same seed. I plant a seed because I'm looking to obtain more later. Well, that's the same thing that come down to you dying. You're not looking to get this. You're looking to get more and better. You have temporary life. You're looking for eternal life. So that should be the attraction and the draw you to trying to give it up. Something has to attract you. Something's got to draw you, spark your interest. Interest is not spark when you're going to give me the same thing I'm getting. Interest is gain. I'm not giving my attention to get the same thing I got. If you let that body go, I'll get that body back up and give it to you. Well, if I don't let it go and keep it, it's the same thing. Come on.
But Elohim giveth it a body as it hath pleased him.
What has happened?
And to every seed his own body.
What happened?
All flesh is not the same flesh.
Talk to me, Brandon.
But there is one kind of flesh of men.
What else?
Another flesh of beasts.
Yeah.
Another of fishes. Mm-hmm. And another of birds. There are also celestial bodies.
And what else?
And bodies terrestrial.
Listen.
But the glory of the celestial is one,
and
the glory of the terrestrial is another.
Y'all see that? Because what are we dealing with? We're dealing with a nous, the glory of the mortal man. That like we look at Adam, we saw a nous, we saw the glory of the mortal man, which is limited. All the rule that he was given, all the authority he was given was under, not over. When we see the glory of the being of Elohim, we see the difference. He got me said, all authority is given to me in Shamayim and in the Aritz. So you can see there's a glory. There's a different glory because we're looking at two different bodies. Y'all got me? You're dealing with the celestial, which they'll use for the Ruach, and you're dealing with the terrestrial. You're dealing with the mortal man. There is a difference in the glory of them. I don't know. Are y'all with me today?
Yes, sir.
I hope so that y'all actually paying attention. And you're trying to be a partaker of the glory of the celestial, as they would say, which would be the Ruach man for, but you're still dwelling with the mindset of the mortal man. The mortal man has to change. The mortal man has to die. Yeah. The person. Listen.
There is one glory of the sun.
Yes.
And another glory of the moon.
What else happened?
And another glory of the stars.
Yes.
For one star differeth from another star in glory.
And you know what they do? They walk around looking at all them stars in that old element trying to see which one brighter than the other. Any person with common sense know it's going to be the sun. They differ in glory. They differ in glory because you're going to look at authority. When the sun shines, he outranks and overrules everything. The sun has to go away for the moon to take on his glory. And the stars. Y'all got me? So that's the same thing you look at when you look at a noose and when you look at the Ruach man. Y'all got me? There's going to be a difference in glory. One's going to overshadow the other. Listen.
So also is the resurrection of the dead.
Listen.
It is sown in incorruption.
And what happens, son?
It is raised in incorruption.
That's what we look at. Again, the reason why we have to actually look at this, because we have to consider our occupation, what we do. We should be familiar with it. There is a difference. A lot of time, a lot of us faint in the way because we don't actually look at, there's a glory in our resurrection. Yes, the death is scary. Yes, the death is without. Yes, the death is totally giving up everything. But then we're going to look at where the glory is. The glory is in the resurrection. The same thing we looked at him. Listen, a lot of time when you look at his speech, we'll find he did a lot of repeating of what was it? What was he repeating a lot of? The what? What was it again? The word. Exactly right. You know why? Because sometimes you got to keep convincing yourself. I'm getting ready to die. It's a mind state you got to be in. It's a mind state you set yourself in. When you got to succumb to death, you got to put the scare, I'm going to die. To some point, you got to get ready to succumb to what you're doing. And what's going to make me succumb to it is I've constantly been doing what the book told me, regurgitating the word, meditating. You know when? Day and night. Talking about it. When I'm in the gates, I've been talking about it. When I lay down, I kept my mind on it. When I get up, I keep my mind on it. You say, I woke up this morning with my mind stayed on it. Because you got to look at what you're getting ready to do. He had to convince himself. Just like a fighter, you got to train. You got to convince yourself saying, you're going to win. What you going to do? It's a mindset you got to be in. That's why a lot of you faint anyway, because you actually don't have a mindset. He told you, let this be in you, which was also in him. That's why I kept talking about it. I keep reminding myself. I got to keep convincing myself. That's the same way we got to come back. Shaul said, furthermore, you have received of us, how you what? Ought to walk. I'm keep reminding you. Because it's a mindset. That's why y'all faint. That's why y'all quit. If somebody say something, something hurt your faith, first thing you quit, you stop. He said, if you faint in the day of adversity, your strength is small. That's why the book told you having to exercise yourself. What you going to do? You're going to get stronger. You exercise. They tell you got weak muscles. What do? You don't do nothing. You pray about them. You cry about them. I need to exercise those muscles to make them stronger. So if my faith is weak, what I need to do? I need to exercise my faith. Which means, what? How am I going to exercise my faith? I'm going to need more word. Because faith come by hearing, and hearing going to come through. So I'm going to get more word if I'm going to get stronger. We're in bad shape. First of all, I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do. If I'm weak, I ain't going to show up. I'm going to stop coming. I'm going to quit. This is the mentality of a fool. Makes no sense. Once they tell you something is weak, then you're going to have to practice. You're going to have to exercise. You have to work on it. The book told you, work out your own soul salvation. Not go to the gym and do workout. Somebody going to sit on the other side of me looking. It ain't going to do nothing for you. You have to work out your own salvation. He said, with fear and trembling. That's what they did when he spoke to them. The people trembled. They were afraid. You need fear. You don't need nobody walking around talking about no fear. You'll be a fool. I got fear of some stuff. You ain't going to take me but so high. I'm afraid of what I can catch myself from. Fear keep me alive. You know, if fear keep you alive, I ain't scared of nothing. I'm just going to walk in the middle of the expressway. You're an idiot. You need fear. When he came and spoke, that's what he was trying to get them. When he made the mountain tremble. When they heard the thunder and the roar, they needed to fear. Amen. You need to fear down. They said, please talk to us. Do not let them speak to us again, lest we die. He said, they well spoken. Because you know what they knew? We are a noose. We are mortal people. We're talking about the Ruach speaking with us. Now, you got somebody speaking to you now on the same level, a mortal man trying to convince you you're going to have to change your application. You have to change the way you work, the way you process stuff. That's why y'all keep saying the same demonic hellhole. Some stuff y'all do just demonic. Makes no sense to keep going backwards. Why in the world I look like getting dumber? Getting stupider when I'm sitting here hearing the word. That man done told him and said in 2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 15. We're going to finish that first Corinthians. 2 Timothy 3 and 15. Let's see what he said. I'm going to get y'all through today. Kind of went a different way, but the word right. Listen.
And that from a child
thou hast known
the who dash scriptures,
which are able
to make thee wise,
through what?
Unto salvation through faith.
It makes sense. How you gonna get saved if you ain't got no faith? That makes no sense, does it? Able to make you wise unto salvation through faith, which means you got to hear the word. You have to obtain something through hearing the word, which it is gonna equal out to salvation. So when y'all sing here, you got to ask yourself, you're hearing the word, why don't you have any faith? Because you don't believe. Now you're going to set yourself into condemnation. He that believeth is immersed. He that believeth not, you're going to be damned. That's the fear. It makes no sense for me to say here and hear the word and not believe. I'm going to be damned. That's condemnation. Why am I trying to? I didn't come to be condemned. He said he that believeth is not condemned. Why y'all sitting here hearing the word and you condemn? That's dumb. That's stupid. I'm hearing the word. There's no way I'm supposed to hear the word and be condemned. Because hearing is supposed to increase my faith. Well, he told them it was impossible, offense must come. But warned them about whom the offense come. It was better that they had a millstone attached around their neck be cast into the depths of the sea. He said, how have your key sinned against thee? And he repent. He said, forgive him. He do it 70 times in one day, he said, forgive him. They said, Yahuwah, what that mean? Now I'm trying, well, I'm just going to have to pray about it. And that's what they said. I'm going to need some more word. Wherever you weak at, you need more word. Y'all get weak, further you do, you die off. You dissipate. You disappear. You draw back. Makes no sense. How you going to get strong? The area you getting attacked on is the area going to take you down. It doesn't make no sense not to get stronger. And that's why I'm weak. I'm going to work on it. I'm a boxer. I got a weak gut. What I need to do? Work on my punching? Huh? What I work on? My eye coordination. Footwork. Work on that core. Because once the person I'm fighting catch on and realize I got a weak core, I'm done. Now, all that jabbing I'm doing ain't no good when somebody take me out from the core. All that footwork ain't no good when I get a good gut hit, is it? Now, you sit here, you know you weak. You know you can't hear nothing. You know you can't see nothing. What you need to work on? You need more words so you can increase your faith, because that's how the enemy going to take you down. Yeah. Once he know that's where your problem is, that's where he going to work on, that's where he going to get you to fall away at. That's why y'all need to be here to hear the word. And they realize, I got to forgive a man 70 times in one day? I know I need more word. I ain't no use to me praying. I need some word, because I'm not there. You can't afford to sleep when you look at where you at. Some of y'all can't take the darn wind blowing. Come on, son, finish this up.
Which is in the Mashiach, Yahusha.
Come on back to 1 Corinthians 15:33. I'm going to try to get y'all out of here. Listen.
Continue to verse 43. It is sown in dishonor.
And it is what?
It is raised in glory.
Come on.
It is sown in weakness. It is raised in power.
Listen.
It is sown a natural body.
And what happened?
It is raised a spiritual body.
That makes sense. Got a body of the Ruach. Look what has happened.
There is a natural body.
Y'all pay attention. There's a natural body, and what else is it?
And there is a spiritual body.
What? Tell them what happened.
And so it is written.
The what?
The first Anus, Adam, was made a living soul.
Mortal man. Anus was made a mortal man. He was made a mortal person. Y'all got me? The first Anus. Tell me about the second one.
The last Adam.
The last
was made
Adam.
A quickening Ruach.
The reason why it lasts, you got to look at the first estate. Got to look at the first estate. Listen to what else he told you.
Howbeit, that was not first, which is Ruach.
But what?
But that which is natural.
You know why I have to look at that? Because now, when I start to look at these situations, everything that we look at, what the Mashiach has done, all of it works from a spiritual standpoint. But in order for me to understand that, I had to see the natural first. There's nothing I understand about him that I ain't see natural. Go back again to about a sheet 1 and 1. Let's just look at a couple of things. Just recap and we're going to go. The Most High will. Okay. I got to put this together right quick in my mind at the same time. I had to work all that out of my mind right quick. Y'all all right? So it'd be different. I had notes. When I think about it, so I got to put it in my mind, how to put it together, see if it all makes sense. We're going to go back to battle sheet 1-1. Just a recap. Slight recap, we're going to get through and get y'all out. This we do the Most High permit. Battle sheet 1-1. Listen.
Barashit, Elohim, created the Shamayim and the Aritz. And the Aritz was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Ruach of Elohim moved upon the face of the waters. And Elohim said, let there be light. And there was light.
Okay, right there, good. The reason why we went back, just kind of recap it. This is all, in a sense, natural. This is natural. Because this happened first. Although we're dealing with the Ruach, this is natural. Now we understood it for the mere fact that he was on the two and the people were surrounded by him. So now we look at something that looked natural, but it actually happened in a spiritual sense. That's how we know it wasn't moving, because that didn't make sense he was moving. He was hovering. He was right in one place. Now, your book say moving, looked like he was zip, zip, but he wasn't. He was on the tutors in one place. Just like Nakum Yah, he was above the people. He was not moving zip, zip over the people. He was hovering above the people. Something had him there. So you start looking at a spiritual aspect, even though the two held him there, you start looking at a spiritual concept now. And showing you, at the fifth chapter of the book of Yehukanon, 5:17. Who know why I called it? Because it rhymes. Ain't no other reason to call it, is it? Listen.
But Yahushua answered them.
Tell them what he said.
My Abba worketh hitherto.
My Abba worketh hitherto.
And I work.
And I work. Listen.
Therefore, the Yahudim sought the more to kill him, because he not only had broken Shabbat,
but did what?
But said also that Elohim was his Abba.
Listen, what else happened?
Making himself equal with Elohim.
Y'all hear this? Hitherto my Abba work, I do the same thing. So now, when other time we gonna find he was hovering above the people like that? Now we start to look at pattern. He was above the people. We started to watch these different behaviors and what he did. Y'all got me? Now, when you come back down again to the Barashit, we start to see pattern of behavior. Even when he left and the cloud received him out of their sight. He again showing you again him working. Listen to the book.
And Elohim saw the light that it was good. And Elohim divided the light from the darkness, and Elohim called the light Yom, and the darkness he called night.
Come on.
And the evening and the morning were Akkad Yom.
We talked about it's going to be one day that's going to be known with him, that at evening time, it should be light. That's how we learned it. Akkad. Huh? Same thing we look at him. He told you that he was the Aleph and the Two. Listen.
And Elohim said, let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters. And Elohim made the firmament and divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament, and it was so.
Listen what has happened.
And Elohim called the firmament Shamayim,
and
the evening and the morning were Shani Yom.
Listen.
And Elohim said, let the waters.
Pay attention. Let the waters.
Under Shamayim.
Do what?
Be gathered together.
Well.
Unto one place.
That's important for you. Because he told you that where the carcass is, there shall the vultures be gathered. When he told them to be gathered, they knew exactly where they were supposed to come to. When he told him to gather my saints together under me, where are they going? To America? To Europe? Where are they going to? China? Where else they going to go? Where the carcass is. When he told the war to be gathered, they knew exactly where they were supposed to be in one place. Same thing with us. We know exactly where we're supposed to go. That's why we're here. That's exactly why we're here, to pay attention. The only reason it makes sense, I got to go back and start looking at what happened from a natural standpoint that makes me understand when he comes. That lets me know exactly what's going to happen. I have a concept because of what I've seen here. What I've heard here is actually going to happen on a spiritual sense for us. Okay. This is a creation for us. But we come back to look at the same thing going to happen in the end. Same thing while it happened in the end. Think about it. When he was up on the tube, they were all gathered. They were right there. He was hovering right there above the people. That's what he wound up doing. Huh? And he wound up separating himself. He wound up taking himself away from us. And then he said, let the waters be gathered together, which of the people be gathered together in one place. Because he's coming back. We know exactly. First of all, they had to be separated. Guess when? Right after he got through hovering. What happened to us after he got through hovering up on the tube? He told us, if you smite the shepherd, what's going to happen? Sheep get the water. If I break the glass, guess what happened to the water? It's going to disperse. See, it all makes sense. But then he gave me confirmation and let me know, but then I'm going to call the waters right back to one place. I don't know what these people doing. Even he told you when Yehuchanan told you that he saw New Jerusalem coming down. Yes, ordained just like a bride. And there were no more what? Seas. That's what he called all the different bodies of water. It ain't going to be all these different people. It's going to be one. That's why he told them to gather together in one place. All these different bodies of water were seas. Yehuchanan said, it wasn't no more sea. It's going to be one. I don't know what y'all are doing. All I'm understanding, I got to pay attention to what he said. I'm going to gather together in one place. It's not going to be all these different denominations. It ain't going to be all these different types of people. It ain't going to be but one people. I don't know what these folks doing. Y'all can mess around y'all one time. It ain't going to be but one. Everybody gonna be the same. How you gonna be here? You gonna be in the congregation. You gonna be a Gentile. You gonna be a Christian, an atheist, a Republican, a Democrat, a Libertarian, Independent. It's not gonna be. Ain't gonna be. All the world gonna be gathered in one place. Huh? He just told you. Even he told. We read the book of Yahuwah. He told you what he did. He said, "My determination." You ain't gonna believe this. To gather all the water down to the valley of Jehoshaphat. There, I'll plead with them for my inheritance. Let the waters be all gathered in one place. See, they don't understand it. I shouldn't have believed it if I ain't believed by the sheet. When you start listening to these prophets, they told you, you shouldn't have believed it. That's only one witness. Where else did you find he done called all the waters in one place? All he was doing was declaring the end at the beginning. Once that man was put up on the tube, you should already know he was hovering above her if it be a disbursement. Let's see what he told her. Oriah. Oriah 1936. Malcolm 18 prom. When he tried to take that white girl to the prom. We need desegregation. Listen.
And as he went, they spread his clothes in the way.
Think about that before you think. Think before you speak. As he went, they spread his clothes in the way.
And as he went, they spread their clothes in the way.
Come on.
And when he was come nigh, even now at the descent of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to rejoice and praise Elohim with a loud voice for all the mighty works that they had seen, saying, Blessed be the Moloch that cometh in the name of Yahuwah, Shalom in Shamayim, and glory in the highest. And some of the Pharisees from among the multitude said unto him, Ruler, rebuke thy disciples.
Come on.
And he answered and said unto them, I tell you that if these should hold their shalom,
so what's going to happen?
The stones would immediately cry out.
Come on.
And when he was come near, he beheld the city and wept over it.
Tell him why.
Saying, If thou hadst known, even thou, at least in this thy yom.
See that? In the yom. Well, what happened?
The things which belong unto thy shalom.
But tell him what happened.
But now they are hid from thine eyes.
Y'all see that? The sight. It's hid from your sight. Hid from the eye. From the Come on.
For the yamim shall come upon thee, that thine enemies shall cast a trench about thee, and compass thee round, and keep thee in on every side, and shall lay thee even with the ground, and thy children within thee, and they shall not leave in thee one stone upon another, because thou knewest not the time of thy visitation.
See that? We didn't know we were supposed to be gathered. So now they come along and they're writs. That's what separated you. When he called for the firmament, he was calling for the writs to come up and separate you. Look at how we've been dispersing all these islands, thinking they Puerto Ricans and thinking they were St. Lucians and Bahamians and thinking they Dominicans and Dominicans and all these other Jamaicans, and then we thinking we Americans and thinking they Cubans. We didn't realize the writs came up and separated the waters. Came up and separated us. Which is the people. Look at how we divide now by the land. What separated the people? The land. Same color skin. I'm arguing about an island. He told you what we're going to separate you. The land going to wind up separating you. But then he told you, I'm going to gather my saints together. I'm sorry, gather my water together unto me. Though they made a covenant by sacrifice. See, that's why I told you, you can't understand this unless you understand by the sheet. This whole concept coming on now that you can actually begin to see this stuff starting to work for you now. Now, just like he told you, where the carcass is, there shall the vultures be gathered. Eagles are killers. Eagles don't sit around and they don't sit around and scavenge, they kill. Vultures scavenge. They scavenge what's already dead. That's why we're coming back. We got a homing system. He done already died. We can pick it up, approximately 5 mile radius. That's how they knew. Just like when Abraham, after he had to sit there, he divided all the carcasses, but the birds he divided not. When he fell asleep, guess what happened? They came in. And he took a stick and started to beat them away. They only did what their home assistant told them. Something died. We homed in. Okay, trying to help y'all out. Come on, let's look at something. Shephatim, for those watching, you're going to call it Judges, 14 and 6. I told them to let y'all go. Let's just look at something. That's all. Shephatim, 14 and 6. I'll see if I put this together all right. Listen.
And the Ruach of Yahuwah came mightily upon him.
Back it up, verse 5. Tell them what happened.
Then went Shamshun down, and his father and his mother.
Y'all pay attention. Then went him down to his father and mother in Timnah. And what happened, Brandon?
And came to the vineyards of Timnath.
Yes.
And behold, a young lion roared against him.
Y'all hear that? A young lion roared against him. Uh-huh.
And the Ruach of Yahuwah came mightily upon him.
And the Ruach of Yahuwah came mightily upon him. And tell him what happened.
And he rent him as he would have rent a kid.
He did what?
He rent him as he would have rent a kid.
And tell him what happened.
And he had nothing in his hand, but he told not his father or his mother what he had done.
All right, at the book of Matthew, Yahoo, chapter 26, 24. Matthew, Yahoo. Listen.
The bend of a noose goeth, as it is written of him, But woe unto that Anus by whom the being of Anus is betrayed.
Listen, why?
It had been good for that Anus if he had not been born.
Mm-hmm.
Then Yehuda, which betrayed him, answered and said, Ruler, is it I? And he said unto him, Thou hast said. And as they were eating, Yehusha took bread and blessed it. And
he did what?
Yehusha took bread.
And did what?
Blessed it.
And did what?
Break it. And gave it to the disciples.
What did he have in his hand? He had nothing in his hands. He had nothing in his hands. He just took bread and he broke it. And you know how he broke it? Just like he would have did a kid. I don't think that's important for you because you were taught in the 12th chapter of the book of U'ala Shemut that you're supposed to take a goat, take a sheep, or a goat from among the herd.
Yeah.
And that's what you were supposed to be killing. Yeah. So this bread, listen to what he told you.
And said, take, eat.
This
is my body.
Which is what?
And he took the cup and gave thanks.
Oh, what you got, son? Jump on, give me your Ukanah 129. Tell them what he's saying. The next what happened?
The next yom.
What happened?
Yochanan seeth Yahushua coming unto him.
He seen who coming?
Yahushua coming unto him.
He saw his reflection coming?
Yahushua coming unto him.
And tell him what he told him.
And saith, Behold, the Lamb of Elohim, which taketh away the sin of the world.
All reason he did it, he was trying to confirm to you. If he just sat down with them and told them to take, eat, this is my body, what did he just break? Well, he actually took a lion. And he did it just like he would have did a kid. And had nothing in his hand. At the book of Kazun, chapter 5, at verse 6. I'm proving it out to him. All right, I say, the only way it's going to make sense, we got to look at the book. Look at the equivalent. Let's see what he killed. Listen to the book. This is Kazun 5 and 6. Tell him what happened.
And I beheld, and lo.
Listen what he saw.
In
he
the
beheld,
midst.
And who?
And I beheld.
And lo.
In the midst of the throne and of the four living creatures.
Y'all pay attention. And the four living creatures. Tell what you're seeing, son.
And in the midst of the elders.
What did he see?
Stood a lamb.
Y'all pay attention. Now he just sat here and just told you, behold, the Lamb of Elohim. Now Yehukanan said he just stood here and he just looked and he in the midst of the throne and in the midst of the 24 elders, in the midst of the four living creatures, he said, I just beheld a who?
Stood a lamb.
As it what?
Had been slain.
Just like it been slain. Tell them what happened.
Having seven horns.
And what else?
Seven eyes.
Which are what?
The seven ruachs of Elohim.
Do what?
Sent forth into all the arits.
Tell them what happened.
And he came and took the book out of the right hand of him that sat upon the throne.
And what happened?
When he had taken the book.
What he saw?
The four living creatures and 24 elders fell down before the Lamb.
Yeah.
Having every one of them harps and golden vials full of odors, which are the prayers of saints.
Yeah.
And they sung a new song.
Jump up at verse 5. Listen.
And one of the elders saith unto me.
Weep what?
Not.
For what happened?
Behold, the Lion of the tribe of Yehuda, the root of Daud, hath prevailed to open the book and to loose the seven seals thereof.
And what happened?
I beheld. And lo, in the midst of the throne and of the four living creatures.
Tell them what it could have been.
And in the midst of the elders.
What was it?
Stood a lamb.
Now you just heard about the lion first. Then you heard about the lamb. Well, guess what wound up running on Shamshun? A lion. And you know how he ran it? Just like he'd have did a sheep. So he just sat at the table. He told you to take, eat. This is my what? So he just killed a lion. He tore it just like he'd have did a lamb. Because you was in your feast. They don't know what they're doing, do they? They just don't know no better. He just told you about it. I don't know why y'all jumped the lamb. It was a lion first. I just tore it just like I'd have tore the sheep. I tore a sheep. Because you were supposed to divide it with your house. That's how I know how to kill it. Man, I don't know what these folks doing. I'm trying to tell you, but they don't know. Look at Matthew Yahoo 2 and 20. Listen.
Saying, arise and take the young child and his mother and go into the land of Yasharal.
What happened?
For they are dead which sought the young child's life.
Yeah.
And he arose and took the young child and his mother and came into the land of Yasharal.
And tell him what happened.
But when he had heard that Archelaus did reign in Yehuda in the room of his father Herod, he was afraid to go thither.
Yeah.
Notwithstanding, being warned of Elohim in a dream, he turned aside into the parts of Galilee.
Mm-hmm.
And he came and dwelt in a city called Nazareth.
And what happened?
That it might be fulfilled.
Tell them what they're going to be saying.
Which was spoken by the prophets.
That what happened?
He shall be called a Nazarene.
All that made sense. So they should have picked it up when he sat at the table with him and took the bread and said, take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you. I just took a lion and I rid of the kid, just like I did the kid. If it's my body, I'm the lion of the tribe of Yehuda. I just tore it just like I would have did a lamb. They don't know what they're doing, do they? Yaakov sat there and told you that Yehuda was a lion's whelp from the prey. He stooped down and he crouched just like an old lion. And said, who gonna rouse him up? And told you the scepter should not depart from Yehuda, nor a lawgiver between his feet unto who? To whom it belonged. To whom it belonged. That's why he's going to live up the king. He got to give it back over. To whom it belonged. Same thing they had to give it back over. Because you do his bloodline, you're going to follow that Yehuda going to be his father too. He told you, hitherto my father work, I do to what was it? So we're only going to count him. We're not going to ever count him as a noose. He was a martyr man as well. When we read Romans the first chapter, it clearly told you he was the son of Daoud, according to the who? Mortal man. He was declared to be the being of Elohim according to authority. So I ain't going to do what none of the rest of them do. This is not my only father. I ain't going to do what none of the rest of them do. When he come back here and deliver us, who is he mimicking? Abraham. Wow. Said, for this call, he's not ashamed to call them. What was it? Brother, that's what our key. That's the same thing that Abraham said about Lot. Yeah. What y'all think he's coming back to do? He's coming back, and guess what he's coming back with? You ain't going to believe it. With his trained soldiers. Those his own house. He told you hitherto. That's why I tell you they don't know what they're doing. That's his father's. He's going to mimic them. Wow, that's amazing. We in bad shape, though. Let's look at something. Chapter 16, 21. Other brother, you give me Matthew Yahoo 27 about 47. We'll read down right quick. I try to get rid of them, go. Well, see what I'm saying? It's a lot of stuff been missed. People don't even pay attention to this. What he sat down at that table and did, that was spiritual. That was of the Ruach. They missed it. Now, you heard how the Ruach came on Shamshun and what he did, but you ain't look at it. This was spiritual right here, or what we call spiritual. You just sit here and a man just took bread and told you this is my body, which he just told you I'm killing a lion. And I tear it just like I do a lamb. What's going with your feast? How hard is it to tear bread? But what if the bread is a lion? Listen.
But the Philistines took him and put out his eyes and brought him down to Gaza and bound him with fetters of brass, and he did grind in the prison house. Howbeit, the hair of his head began to grow again after he was shaven. Then the rulers of the Philistines gathered them together for to offer a great sacrifice unto Dagon their god and to rejoice. For they said, our God have delivered Shamshun, our enemy, into our hand. And when the people saw him, they praised their God, for they said, our God hath delivered into our hands our enemy and the destroyer of our country, which slew many of us.
Y'all see that? Same thing when they look at Yahushua. They've been rejoicing too, they've been delivered in their hands. That man done tore down everything he folk believed. That man was killing out a system, a whole governmental system. You know how happy they would have been if that man had been delivered? This man done went inside the temple and overturned tables of the money changers. This man done messed up a whole system. You know how happy these people were when they got this man, he was delivered to them? They took his eyes out. That's why they blindfolded him. He should be called a Nazarene. Listen.
And it came to pass when their hearts were merry, that they said, call for Shamshun, that he may make us sport. And they called for Shamshun out of the prison house, and he made them sport, and they set him between the pillars.
Wow. Set him between two thieves. One on the right hand and another on the left. That's not when they brought Yahushua out. They were making sport of him. Again, looking at the Greek. See, everybody been finding the same system. Bringing us out, making sport of us. Same way they bring these blacks out, make a fool out of you. They brought him out to make sport of him. Listen.
And Shamshun said unto the lad that held him by the hand, suffer me that I may feel the pillars whereupon the house standeth, that I may lean upon them.
Yeah.
Now the house was full of men and women, and all the rulers of the Philistines were there. And there were upon the roof about 3,000 men and women that beheld while Shamshun made sport.
Yeah.
And Shamshun called unto Yahuwah and said, O Yahuwah Al-Ahim, remember me, I pray thee, and strengthen me, I pray thee, only this once, O Al-Ahim, that I may be at once avenged of the Philistines for my two eyes.
Listen.
And Shamshun took hold of the two middle pillars upon which the house stood and on which it was borne up, of the one with his right hand and of the other with his left. And Shamshun said, let me die with the Philistines. And he bowed himself with all his might, and the house fell upon the rulers and upon all the people that were therein. So the dead which he slew at his death.
The what now?
The dead which he slew at his death.
What?
More than they which he slew in his life.
At the 27th chapter of the book of Netanyahu. 27:47. Listen.
Some of them that stood there, when they heard that, said, this man calleth for all Yahu.
Yeah.
And straightway.
Wow. Guess what? Shamshun was calling on him. What happened?
And straightway, one of them ran and took a sponge and filled it with vinegar and put it on a reed and gave him to drink.
Come on.
The rest said, let be, let us see whether all Yahu will come down to save him.
Yeah.
Yahusha, when he had cried again with a loud voice, yielded up the ruach.
What happened?
And behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain.
Wow. Wow, that's amazing. He kept telling me we were going to destroy it. They were thinking about the natural. He told me we could destroy the temple. Saying, 3 days, I'm going to build it back. The veil of the temple was rent. What else happened?
From the top to the bottom.
From the top to the bottom. They had people standing on the top and at the bottom. What else happened?
And the rich did quake. And the rocks rent.
Listen.
And the graves were opened.
And what happened?
And many bodies of the saints which slept arose.
Shamshun killed more in his death. He brought back the life more in his.
Amen.
He had been known for raising Lazarus. Y'all know him for Lazarus, bringing Lazarus from the dead. He brought back more in his death than he did in the living.
Amen.
Once he looked at where the whole place was standing at, and guess what? He wound up dying with them and brought them right back. That's why we love him. That's why I tell y'all, understand the concept, we had to go back to look at our law. I know it seems like it's drawn out. It's a long time, and it is a lot of work. But at the same time, trying to get y'all to understand the concept, though, we're trying to make sure that you obtain the faith. Because if you don't obtain the faith, you're not going to be saved. You can't obtain the faith if you're not getting taught the word. But what you're hearing, you got to use application. Y'all hear me? Amen. And you got to demonstrate your faith by when situations come up, when things happen, arousal come. Y'all hear me? When that pickle want to get tickled, when them buttons want to get pushed. Y'all hear me? Or when you desire to go get drunk or get high or any other stuff you want to do, go curse and lie or any other stuff you do, you got to set that stuff aside. You're going to be a saved if you're looking to be saved in the last day. Huh? You got to lay aside every, what was it? And now y'all got too many weights. That's why I tell all my obese members to lose weight. He told you to lay aside all the weight and the sin. A lot of stuff you got some weight to you. If you keep it out of the water, it's going to become a sin because it's going to hinder you from doing the work. Just being honest. Even when you play football, they got weight requirements, don't they? Because you know what they look at? That weight is going to hurt you in your obligations. You're not on the line. It don't make sense for you to have that weight. If I got a man on the line blocking or trying to get through, I need him to be heavy. I need somebody that can't move. But if I got a man running the ball, I need you to stay a specific way. So you got to lay aside every weight and the sin that beset you, that head you in. Y'all got me? There's a lot of stuff y'all got going on in here, other than that camera in this room, that's going to hold you in. It's going to keep you from being saved. That's good, brother.
Amen.
Make it most high. Make it most high.